Welcome back to Adobe's Learn from the Pros tutorial series. I'm Boone from Boonless Video. In the last episode, we created this animated map path with some markers. In this episode, I'm getting everything set up and ready for animation inside of 3D space. So this is a pretty simple project right now. I've got these five map marker shape elements, my path shape layer, and my map layer. Now I want to rig these up in a way that when they become 3D objects, if I make any changes to the map layer, naturally I want the path and the map markers to stick to the map. However, I do want to have the ability to pull that path and those map markers away from the map so that when I add lighting, I have nice shadows cast on the map and I can achieve a really nice three-dimensional look. So to rig this up, I'm going to right-click in my timeline panel and go to New Null Object. This is going to be my path controller. So I'm going to hit Enter and rename it Path Controller. And now I'm going to grab all the map markers as well as the path, and I'm going to parent these to the path controller. And then to have this follow the map, I'll simply parent the path controller null to the map. Now everything's properly rigged up and I can switch all these elements to 3D. And I'm going to do that via these little checkboxes here. If you can't see them, go down to the toggle switches and modes button and simply click on that. If you can't see this button, toggle it on over here. So now I'll go and I'll switch all these to 3D. Now after I do that, if you go over here to the comp panel, you're going to see there's all these new parameters available to me, one of which is the 3D view. Now over here it says active camera default. Now I didn't add any camera layers. However, when you switch layers to 3D, it automatically adds what's called the default camera. And you can control this default camera using the camera tools up here. So you have orbit, you have pan, and you have dolly. And if you click and hold, you'll see there's subcategories of these tools to give you different ways to control these tools. So here I can orbit around the scene. Now you can see I'm making adjustments to my default camera. I can toggle between these camera tools by hitting the C key. Now I'm gonna drag out, now I'm dollying out. If you find that your system is a little laggy and it really can't hang, there's a little button down here that's called Draft 3D. And if I click this, this is gonna switch to what's called the RTE renderer. It's the real-time engine renderer. And it's gonna allow you to work in kind of like real time. It's gonna be real punchy and responsive. So this is really designed to assist your animation workflow and allow you to work really quickly. It also has a 3D ground plane here. So if I turn this on, you can see this really helps me figure out where I am in 3D space. And with the new April 2022 release of Adobe After Effects, we now have the new extended viewport. So if I toggle this on, you can't really see what it's doing, but I'm gonna switch to dolly and I'm gonna dolly in. And now I'm actually gonna zoom out of my comp window here. You can see this is the parameters of my composition. See if I toggle extended viewport off, this is what it looked like before. So this is just a really great way to also see what's going on in 3D space. And if you wanna, you know, zoom in a little bit further. And if I click and hold on extended viewport, you can see that I can control the transparency amount or the opacity of the extended viewport. Incredibly helpful. You'll notice that I can't add keyframes to my default camera. So I need to actually go and add a new camera. Now I can right click right on the comp panel here. And there's a little menu group here called camera. And you can see that I can create a camera automatically from my current default camera 3D view, which is pretty cool, but I don't wanna do that. I'm just gonna go ahead and reset the default camera. That's gonna snap it back. Now I can just right click down here and go to new camera. There are two different types of cameras you can create. You can see over here in type, if I open this up, you have one and two node cameras. So a one node camera essentially creates a camera layer that has only position parameters, whereas a two node will have position parameters as well as a point of interest. Since this is a pretty basic project, I'm gonna stick to one node camera, and then I'm gonna go over here to preset, and I'm gonna select the 50 millimeter preset, and then all the other default parameters are just fine. Now I'm gonna click okay. I can now see a new camera layer. And over here, I can now see that active camera is camera one. So if I make any adjustments now with my camera control tools, it's going to be controlling camera one. However, I can still switch back to default camera, which is very, very helpful. See, watch what happens now. I'm moving my default camera around, which is very helpful. I can get a bird's eye view of my project here as I move around and see there is my new camera. So now when I'm animating this camera, if I switch to default view, I can really see what's going on. In fact, I'm gonna switch this to two views. This is a viewport controller here. I can switch this to two views. And then on the right here, with this selected, I can switch this to active camera, camera one, and this one to default camera. This is really cool because you can switch this viewport to whatever you want. You know, you can switch it to like looking down the left, and then you can, you know, see what your camera's doing here, which is in fact the way we'll be working in a minute. Another new feature being introduced in the April 2022 release of Adobe After Effects are these new 3D icons. So this is what's called binning, and it's essentially showing you how 3D layers are going to be rendered. And if they're binned together, they basically will be able to intersect each other and cast lights and shadows on each other. However, if I were to go to new adjustment layer, or I added some kind of 2D layer in between these, watch what happens. It breaks the bins. So now, for example, these two 3D objects will not intersect with each other because I've broken them here. So this doesn't change the way that After Effects is functioning. It's essentially a UI enhancement. It's just giving you a better way to see what's going on inside of the 3D world. Now, if I go back up here to the comp panel and I select my 3D map, you're gonna see this colorful little tool here. This is the 3D Gizmo or widget, and it allows you to quickly control 3D layers from directly inside the comp panel. I can control the position, the scale, and the rotation all with this one tool. You can see as I hover my mouse over, you get these tooltips showing you the various axes that I can grab here. So here, if you see an ellipse, that is where you can control rotation. This is the X rotation here. I could mess with Z rotation. And if I see an arrow here, this controls the actual position. So I can move the position on each individual axis. And if I grab a square, that is gonna scale it. So you can see I can scale it just by Y, I can scale it just by X. This tool is incredibly handy. It helps you avoid having to dive down into the actual timeline, transformation properties, and edit things in this method. Now we know how to look at our scene from various angles. We know how to navigate 3D space. For the next step, I'm gonna get things rigged up. So if you remember from the sample animation, the map is lying flat and the camera is kind of flying over it, looking down at a slight angle. So to rig this up, I can come over here and grab my map, and then I can grab the X rotation. And let's say I just wanna make it flat on the ground plane. So to do that, I can move X rotation and I can hold shift, and I have a little tooltip readout here. So if I turn it 90 degrees on X rotation, now you can see it is flat with the plane. And you can really see it here because our active camera is looking straight down, so it's kind of become invisible because we're looking straight down this plane. Now, what I want to do is position the camera so that we're right over top of it looking down on it. The best way to do this is to switch this viewport to left, and I'm going to grab the Y position and just bring it up a little bit like this. And now we can start to bring it way up closer to the map. And now I'll grab the X rotation of this, and I can set the rotation to maybe something like about 20, I think is good. And now we're over top of the map, we're looking down at the map. However, I want to be aligned with the path. So to do that, I can just grab this here, and I can control my map just by rotating a little bit. So I'm going to rotate it by the Y so that it rotates it, so that now we are looking down the path, and it's nice and centered up here like this. And there you have it. You saw how easy that was to rig up. All right, now that we know how to navigate 3D space and are feeling a little more comfortable, in the next video, we're gonna add some lights.